الرحمن الرحيم. Our case today is common Arab board, Saudi board, Jordanian board, and also you can visit during you are discharging patient from the postnatal ward or in nursery. We'll see our case here. You are asked to see child in consultations. The family noticed that the child left arm and the leg seemed bigger than those of the right. If you see here, this is in this illustrations. You see here, if you see here, this is, you see the right side is bigger than that left side. There is discrepancy. There is hemihypertrophy between, or there is discrepancy between the lower limb, between the left and right. The right, it's actually, it's bigger than the left. So in additional to that, you did the red reflex. It was abnormal red reflex, or there is evidence of an iridia, is no iris. You examined the family member present, and none of them have an iridia or hemihypertrophy. So it's negative family history of an iridia and hemihypertrophy. Do they know anyone else in the family with this condition? The other family member doesn't have an iridia or hemihypertrophy. So you suggest further evaluation of the child for which condition? So you are looking for what, or you are searching for which tumor it will be associated with an iridia and hemihypertrophy. So it will be Wilms tumor. Wilms tumor, nephroblastoma. Nephroblastoma. What is the syndrome associated with Wilms tumor? It will be Wagner syndrome. It will be Wilms tumor and iridia and genitourinary abnormalities and mental retardations. Other syndrome, it will be Drash syndrome. It will be intersex or male pseudohermaphroditism and progressive glomerulonephritis or nephrotic syndrome or nephrotic syndrome. And the other syndrome, it will be Beckwith-Wiedemann syndrome. It will be hypoglycemia, hemihypertrophy, and iridia and the ear beats. It all will be associated. And the other syndrome, it will be Silver-Russell syndrome. Also, it will be associated with hemihypertrophy. So Wilms tumor and iridia, it's found almost 1 to 2% of children with Wilms tumor. And there is genito, you have to examine the baby for genitourinary anomalies. Almost 4 to 5% from the cases it will be associated, and hemihypertrophy associated with this tumor pie 2 to 3% of the patient. 2 to 3% of the patient. So an iridia 1 to 2, hemihypertrophy 2 to 3, and genital abnormalities it will be 4 to 5% from the cases. And Wilms tumor, this is the most common primary renal malignancy in childhood. Renal malignancy in childhood. Presentation, it will present with 3H, hypertension and hematuria and renal megaly or renal mass. It will be renal mass, renal mass, usually abdominal mass and sometimes hypertension, hematuria and abdominal pain and fever. Prognosis in general, it's good. Prognosis is generally good. So during you are discharging patient from the nursery, and you will see here there is hemihypertrophy, or there is one side, there is discrepancy between the left and right side, and there is abnormal red reflex and abnormal genitourinary, you have to think about Wilms tumor. You have to think about Wilms tumor, and you have to request for ultrasound in the CT. Then you consult the nephrologist or the pediatric surgery. ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا. سلام عليكم.